losing that, losing like also like not just my sister and like the closest person in my life, but losing the support system I had within my family, especially as a queer person, a gay person, that was a loss I realized was that died too when she was gone.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to my show.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
How Mother Studio. This is my pride story, as you know.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
I'm fine. For people who doesn't know you yet, what is your name? What is your age? Where are you from? What do you do in life? You know, like every other mom, Jewish mom question.
Sure. My name is John Prezant. I'm 28. I grew up in northern New Jersey. In the States, and I made Aliyah and moved to Israel about 2 years ago, and I'm studying social work to become a therapist.
This is impressive and impactful, and I'm very grateful for you to be here. How do you identify yourself, both gender-wise as well as sexual orientation?
I'm gay, cisgendered. My pronouns are he, him, his.
When was the first time that you were actually realized that something might be different about me, you know, different from the norms of society?
Yeah. I think I started to get an idea that I was different when classmates realized that I was different. I started dealing with some bullying once I think my cohort, my age range, started to figure out what gay meant. So I had an idea that I was different because people treated me differently.
At what age exactly?
Around, I think it started around 12, maybe 11, 12. And then I saw Will and Grace for the first time, and that changed everything for me.
Okay.
At the time, it was the only gay lead in a in mainstream entertainment, and I remember identifying so closely to him and feeling like, okay, that's the life that I need to aspire to get out of this hell that's middle school and later high school.
You know, this is just the exact proofs we need, because our show is all about awareness and acceptance and tolerance, and to educate people all over the world that there are more people like us. It's not a secret, right? I hope that, I mean, there will be even more shows like that in the future. So who was that first person that you were actually told him, her, about yourself, that you come and say, this is my feelings, this is my identity?
Yeah, so I took a little while after discovering Will and Grace to actually come out. I was seeing women, and I studied abroad for a semester during college, during my junior year of college.
Where?
I was 20, and I went to London.
Okay.
And in that first week, I met a friend, and I grew up in a very conservative, sheltered environment, so I knew nothing outside of really...
Out of Will and Grace, that's it.
I guess, I guess, like very, I guess like mainstream representations of queer people.
Mm-hmm.
And then I moved to London for a few months, and in that first week, I met a friend who was very queer friendly, very open, and she took me to a gay bar, and I thought it was going to be like so masculine of me to go to be a straight guy in a gay bar, and it would be fine. And so we went out, and in that night, I met my first gay person. Really, I had my first sexual experience with a guy, I had my first kiss with a guy, and I flew out of the closet after that. And so she was the first person I told, my friend then. And then I started to come out more throughout my time then. And then, that summer I came out to my family.
Yeah.
And that's sort of where it started.
How was it for you? I mean, what is the story behind sharing your feelings, your identity with the family?
So while in London, I have two sisters. I have one older one who's a year older than me, and I have a younger one who's 5 years younger. And so my mom and my older sister Stephanie came to visit me for a week, and I was so nervous. I was I decided I was going to come out to them. I was going to come out to my sister.
Okay, for sure.
For sure. I was going to come out to my sister. And then the first day she was there, I didn't do it. The second day she was there, I didn't do it. Third, fourth. Finally, it was the last day. I was like, I have to do it now or else I felt this like, I have to do it now. I can't wait till I go home.
Yeah, like have your rock on your, you know.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And so I told her, I came out to her last night there, and we had like a real connection. I think like
bonding.
The lines between, like older sister, younger brother, that dynamic sort of faded away. And we really bonded and we connected, and I felt so liberated. And my parents at the time, they're great now, but they were very conservative.
Yeah.
And she was very open-minded and progressive, and she was like, I'll help mediate it. We'll come out when you come back from London.
Yeah.
Just give it 1 month. And we had this plan about how I'm going to come out to my parents. She was going to help me. And then she flew back, and 3 weeks later or so, I got a call that she died in a rock climbing accident.
Oh, God.
And I flew back.
It must be a shocker for you. I mean,
it was the trauma of my life so far.
So sorry that you know you need to go through like that.
It was not at the time I was looking forward to just having coming out being the hardest thing I would have to deal with, and it turns out it
and she was
wasn't.
The only person from your family that know
yeah,
you.
Really. At the time, I really viewed her as the only one who could
help you out or
help me out, but really make the family equal. She was sort of the anchor in the family. That was her role as the I think the protector, the supporter, and she was certainly that for me. So losing that, losing like also like not just my sister and like the closest person in my life, but losing the support system I had within my family, especially as a queer person, a gay person, that was a loss I realized was that died too when she was gone.
Yeah, it's kind of leaving you out of nowhere. What can I do now? I have no safe shelter.
That's exactly right. And I flew back, and because of the circumstances, it was a rock climbing accident. She was 22, and she was about to graduate college. She was like 2 weeks until she was set to graduate college. The circumstances were wild, and people talked about us a lot.
Yeah,
my family and about me. And so I fly back and go to the funeral, and there's about 500 people there, and all these people that knew her. That she was friends with in college started coming up to me saying how proud they are of me, how proud she was of me. And I was like, proud of what? I don't get it. And
you're like,
more people,
what? I did nothing. Why?
I did nothing. I told nobody anything. I was like, not even, I had to put that aside. I was really like,
You didn't even grieving. Like the,
I didn't have a second to really start. And I started to realize the more people coming up to me that my sister had told people that I was gay before I did. And because of the circumstances, because people were talking about us, it was spreading. So I had a decision to make, because at that point, people that I had known my whole life found out that I was gay before I even told them. I had to tell my parents before they found out from somebody else. So it was a rough summer. That was in May, and I came out to
the funeral. I can only imagine, So you probably have to tell your parents immediately, or else they will know.
They'll find out from somebody else, And
That's
two bad options, So either they find out from me at the worst time possible, or they find out from somebody else at the worst time possible. And so I chose that it would come from me. And I'm proud of that decision.
I mean, I'm sure that you felt a relief that you told me before your parents are not so accepting. So how did it go, and how is it now?
So at the time it was quite bad because of the circumstances that I could, now that it's been several years, it's been 8 years since I came out to them, I have the room to sort of, I've thought about it endlessly and digested it, and I've grown as a person, and I've become, I think, more empathetic to my parents and their struggle to grow up in such a isolated community than having to become well-versed in an issue that they know nothing about. So I always
telling my friends and followers, we have to give our parents our opportunities, their opportunities to process as well as we need, right?
I think so too. I think that it's different for each person, and I think that each individual needs to judge where their boundaries and where their limits are. For me, it was terrible. It was coming out to them was terrible.
You can laugh about it now, but
yeah, no, I can. And my parents are such allies now. I just went. My mom came for Pride in Israel.
Wow.
And that. So like, it's
you never. Totally I'm sure you never imagined that this could happen, right?
At the time, absolutely not. Absolutely not. It was. It was hard.
Listen, we can talk for hours, but we need to, you know, go to the finish line. What will be your message, first of all, for our community? What do you think our LGBTQ people needs to know?
So I can't speak for the entire LGBTQ community.
Just for yourself.
Yes, but for I could definitely speak to white cisgendered gay men. When I say that, I think what we need to do is be better allies to the trans community. As we've seen our own progress move forward, especially in the States with marriage equality, more equal rights amendments, trans people have been consistently the most vulnerable population within our community.
Right, true.
Without the trans community and gender nonconforming individuals, we wouldn't have had the modern day queer liberation movement. And I think that if we really care about LGBTQ equality, as we say that we do, we need to think in terms of intersectionality, and we need to be better educated, well-versed, and be supporters of the trans movement from an intersectional point of view.
Listen, the trans people are a part of our history. I mean, we cannot build our community without the trans people around us, and they struggle for many years and still. So, as I told you, this is like a short episode, and I'm sure you have I'm sure you have a lot of questions for John. So, first of all, please, if you have any comment, leave it here below. Ask John anything you would like to ask. You must reply and respond.
Be nice.
And I'm extremely grateful for you to come here and share your story, your personal pride story.
Thanks
and
for having me. Yeah.
You're welcome, and
very
I'm
meaningful.
Honored. I'm honored.
Thanks.
Till next time.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.